They're like, you look fine. Why aren't you working? Because as soon as I stand up, I start to sweat buckets and then I pass out. Or because if I get a cold, I'm sick for 3 weeks, not 3 days. Like, who's going to employ me if I get a cold every 3 weeks for 3 weeks? I can't go to work. I can't pass the germs on to people. I get weak. I get tired. Like, people don't see that part of it because I don't show it to them. Because I don't go out when I feel that way. So unless you're one of my very close friends who comes over and sits with me on those days, of course I seem fine. You know, like, or, oh, you look so good. Did you not notice that I have this on right now? Like, this little gadget here? Yeah, I'm fine. I just have something going into my heart to give me medication. Like, yeah, it really makes me angry sometimes that people are like, oh, but you look so good. And I feel like a lot of people say that. You don't look sick. Well, I am. This is what it looks like to be sick in your 30s. Sometimes you look fine. And I think chronic illness in general, people struggle with that, right? But yeah, one of the things that I do, I don't know if you can see them, I'm wearing spoons. Do you know the spoon theory? So the spoon theory was created, I believe, by a therapist for people with chronic illness to think about energy budgeting. Because, you know, when you have chronic illness, you don't have energy to do everything you want to do. And if you think about it, as spoonfuls of energy. Every day you wake up with a whole bunch of spoonfuls of energy, or maybe not a bunch, maybe a couple of spoonfuls. You got to really think about where you want to spend those spoons and how many spoonfuls of energy it's going to take to do each of those things. And for me, that metaphor has been really helpful in helping me realize, like, hey, I don't have enough spoons to do all three of these things today. I'm going to choose one. And I think there's a lot of people that use that. And for me, I use this as, like, I'm a visual person, right? So I make these necklaces that you can add spoons to or take them off. But it's just a really good reminder for me personally, but it's also a really good talking point. People notice these all the time. They're like, are those spoons? And people are like, oh, is it a Coke spoon? I was like, yeah, because I'm just wearing 5 Coke spoons around my neck all the time. No. And then you get to have this conversation about what it's like to live with chronic illness and what it's like to have the energy budget. And it's a really good way to explain that to people with a visual metaphor. So I actually started making these and selling them and giving them away to other cancer patients and chronic illness folk, because I think it's just a really nice way to remind yourself to be kind to yourself and to not overdo it. Because if you spend too many spoons, you have less tomorrow. Or if you save some spoons, you might have some more spoons tomorrow.